winter, long ago, they say, a Norwegian who lived high on a mountain got fed up with waiting for the snow to melt so that he could rejoin his friends in the valley. So he sliced himself a couple of lengths of wood, roped them to his feet, and slid down the mountain. I wonder if he realized what he'd started.
Down there, tucked into the deepest fold of the Ziller Valley in Austria's Tyrolean Alps, is Mayrhofen, a thriving tourist centre intent on slaking the growing international thirst for winter sports. For over 100 years, Mayrhofen only catered for summer visitors. Then, in the 1950s, with the influx of pioneer skiing enthusiasts from Britain, the town transformed itself into a 12-month-a-year family resort. An increasing number of beginners from Britain come here each year between December and April, mostly on package holidays, and are bitten by the ski bug. Many leave converted for life and swearing never again to spend their holidays just lolling on a beach. Here you get an all-action holiday, and they have ways of helping you enjoy it. Ricky and Ernst Spies run the Mayrhofen Ski School, reputed to be among the best in Europe. Ernst, who was an Austrian national champion, is an Olympic winter sports organizer. Ricky, his wife, was the Austrian national champion 7 times and winner of 2 Olympic bronze medals.
And look at me, I turn around, and then you follow me.
The 60 or so teachers, most of whom can conduct lessons in English, divide the classes into grades, starting with novices and progressing through the various stages to advanced skiers. Guess which grade I'm in.
Very good.
Well, Ricky, I'm not quite ready for the Olympics, I guess. How long does it take a complete beginner like me to become a proficient skier?
Oh, if you come over to us with a good condition, you will manage in about a week to do some good snowplow turns and have fun on your skis. You will ski down to the lifts and come up again. And I think this is wonderful.
Well, I'm really encouraged. A week sounds so little. I've heard frightening stories about the danger of breaking legs. I must admit, I haven't so far, but are there many injuries here?
No. You will recognize we have none these days. And I think our safety bindings and also method cuts down all these accidents. We have only 0.02% from all the skiers.
That's practically nothing. Ernst, what does the well-dressed skier wear on the slopes here?
Well, may I ask Brigitte to come here? Yes, may I show you? She's wearing an ideal skiing suit and equipment. You see the trousers and the jacket. You see the cap, the sunglasses on a bright day, and the goggles for a snowy or windy day, and very warm mitts. And don't forget, warm underwear. And a very important thing is the boots, the right boots, the safety boots. They should be a bit higher and solid to fix the ankle. It cuts down the figure of accidents.
Now, this is comparative luxury, really. What are the basics for the starter?
The basics, they just bring a little one, nice trousers, a warm jacket, warm underwear, a cap, mitts, and maybe glasses and goggles. That's enough for the first period.
Ricky, you started the first ski kindergarten in Europe here more than 20 years ago. At what age can children begin?
Our children here start about 4 years old, and we call children until they are 14.
Now, how do they react to being parted from their parents for the day?
Oh, they are very happy with us, and we split all these children in several classes, also in standards, and then after they learn a lot, they go back very happy to their children, to their parents.
The children are met at about 9 a.m. at the cable car station and taken up for their morning lessons. They have lunch in the special school hut or at the mountain restaurant, a brief rest period, then the afternoon lesson. At 4 o'clock, they're brought down the mountain to be collected at the station. The cost of 6 days at the children's ski school, including lunch and lift tickets to the slopes, is about £44. 3 days works out at about £27, plus a small fee for equipment hire. Add to that the cost to your pride, because kids usually take to the slopes like midget thunderbolts while you're still struggling to keep your skis under you. For adults, a course of 12 lessons over 6 days comes to about £20. A single day consisting of 2 2-hour lessons is about £7. You may have to add to those amounts the hire of skis, poles and ski boots if you don't have your own. They can cost another £3 a day. A cable car to the ski slopes and then use of the ski lifts costs £5 a day. If you're not as skillful as these skiers, you can of course take the cable car down at no extra charge. You can reduce some of these costs by arranging them through your tour operator. You might even try one of the 70 or so artificial ski slopes in the United Kingdom, like the one at Torbay, in the hope that it'll save you a few days' tuition when you get here. But remember that in most cases, these essential extras can add considerably to the cost of your package, in some cases even doubling the basic figure. So do your sums carefully when you make your booking.
If you've yet to go on a skiing holiday, the information in the brochures about the height and position of mountains may be somewhat lost on you. So as a very rough guide, the slopes that face north and are the highest should have the longest lasting and most consistent snow. But then again, they may be colder.
Mayrhofen has a selection of mountains to choose from and a well-organized network of ski lifts and runs up to about 7,000 feet. The season here lasts from mid-December to late April. But wherever you go, it's virtually impossible to forecast snow conditions more than a few days ahead. The best you can do is to check with the tour operator which resort should have the best conditions for your requirements at the time you intend going. You reach the slopes on the Ahorn by a cable car situated on the edge of town and served by a frequent ski bus, which is free. The runs, or pistes as they're called, are best suited to beginners and intermediate skiers.
There are tough pistes too for the advanced skier and other challenging runs here on the slopes of the Penken, accessible either from Mayrhofen or the neighbouring skiing village of Finkenberg.
You might fancy Langlaufen, cross-country skiing. Whatever your age, you need only a few minutes training to enjoy its rewards, the magnificent scenery and a sense of exhilaration.
Of course, skiing and Langlaufen aren't the only ways of coming down the mountain. There's also ski bobbing, which can also be learned quickly for those who'd like to take their pleasure sitting down.
Or if you feel that terror shared is terror doubled, you could try one of the long two-seater toboggan runs. And, as you might expect, the hills of Austria's Zillertal are alive not only with holidaymakers, but with the sound of umpa music. Mayrhofen's band entertains in the main square, and there's umpa music in hotels, restaurants and nightclubs throughout the Ziller Valley. And the town keeps in tune with the demand for colourful souvenirs. But while strolling the Hauptstrasse shopping centre, you need the eye of an ibex to pick up any outstanding bargains.
Of course, you can make your own souvenirs if you take a five-day Holschnitzen, that's a wood sculpture course, here under the guidance of the accomplished Albin Moroder. How am I making out, Mr. Moroder?
Oh, it comes out quite well. Good. A little bit deeper, yeah.
A little bit deeper, right. Mind you, the cost, which is around £40, might seem a bit on the steep side if all you emerge with at the end of it is a wooden bowl like this one. Then again, the experience you gain here may help you to try something more ambitious later on.
If you aren't the creative type, you may like to carve your way through this formidable Austrian snack in one of the many sidewalk cafes, the Apfelstrudel, a calorific bombshell. Après-ski, nightlife abounds. There's everything here from modern discotheques to traditional schuhplattling and yodeling evenings, complete with mulled Glühwein, strong Austrian beer, and when you're celebrating, what better than a glass of down-it-in-one schnapps? Prost!
Mayrhofen itself has been celebrating recently what you might call its own silver jubilee, because the town's success story began just 25 years ago when Cliff Howards arrived from Birmingham. Cliff, what attracted you to Mayrhofen in the first place?
Well, as you can see, it's a very beautiful place and very friendly people. And when I first came here, one could see that it had got tremendous potential as a ski centre.
And one of those friendly people is now your missus, of
course.
Yes,
glad to say. Yes, still friendly.
What attractions are there here for the holidaymaker apart from skiing?
Well, there's curling, skating, indoor swimming, bowling, kindergarten to put the kids in when you're doing all those things. And there's a lovely train, steam train, half size, that comes up the valley from Strass. And really, you have to imagine how attractive this is for the people who come really from all over the world. Because most unusual.
Where can you reach from here with ease?
Well, from Mayrhofen, there are five valleys which radiate out in practically every point of the compass. So you can either walk into them or take a post bus and drive through some of the really the most attractive scenery in the Alps.
And Innsbruck, is that worth a trip?
Yes, yes. The motorway in the Inn Valley is finished now, and you can actually do that trip driving time about 40 minutes, very easy.
This is the hotel that accommodated the first big rush of British tourists, the Neue Post. Now it receives visitors from all over the world, while still remaining one of the centres for British visitors. Like many of the other hotels, it has its own nightclub, bars, and a suitably mountainous bill of fare, prepared here by no less than 23 cooks. The service is friendly and efficient. The rooms well furnished, a good proportion with baths or showers. Full board works out at from £8 to £10 a day. A week's package here, including flights via Munich Airport, costs from about £79. The high standards of the Neue Post seem to be reflected in virtually all Mayrhofen's hotels. One of the newest, the Strass Sport, has its own sauna, solarium and swimming pool and is right next to the cable car which takes you to the Penken Mountain. You can also stay at one of the many guest houses which cost about £5 a night.
Something rather odd's going on the slopes today because it happens to be Unsinniger Finstag, Nonsense Thursday, which is part of the annual fashing celebrations.
Yes, the ski bug is alive and well and living happily in Austria. And I may say, it's highly infectious.